This is Martin Shervington, and in this video, we're going to really start exploring Google+. To begin, let's go to the home stream. And as you can see, we have many posts in that stream. And if we click on the hashtag, that will flip the post, and we can find similar content to that original hashtag. Now, if you click on the actual hashtag at the top itself, that will take you to a dedicated stream as if you searched in the top bar with that hashtag. As with on the home stream, if there are new images, if you click on the refresh, that will bring them up. And also, if you click resume, that will take you to the one where you were. And there's a little marker to show you roughly where you were. Coming back to the top, coming across, you can filter by best of, or most recent, by people and pages, communities, specifically Google Plus posts, photos, and then under the more option, you can look specifically for Hangouts, for events, from content just from within your circles, content from you, or content to you. Now, this is a very powerful way of finding the information you want. Also in this area, you'll see trending. Trending means that these are popular topics on Google+, and they've been spoken about at the time. There's a mix of hashtags and individual words or phrases. And if you look, there are ones that are going up, ones that are going down, and ones with a dot that are staying the same. When you click on one of these trending topics, it will create a search for that particular word as it would when you just search in the box. So this is a really good shortcut. Then you can have a look at the content in that stream. And as always, you can plus one, you can comment, or you can share that content and add your own comments at the top before sharing. Next, let's jump to an area on Google Plus called What's Hot and Recommended. If you come to the sidebar and click on the flame for What's Hot, that will take you to popular content that has been recommended for you. Sometimes you'll see this content in your stream. Now, the way to decide how much content you see of this in the stream is to click on the gear cog, the same as you would for a circle, and then either check or uncheck that box, and then decide on the right amount for you. And I have mine set as standard, and that works. And if you wanted, you have fewer or you have more. It's not just posts that you find in this area. You'll also have suggestions of communities you may like, and you can also search in the box, and interest in people and pages. When you see a video you're interested in, just click on the play button and you can play directly within Google+. You can also mute and you can watch it on YouTube, and that will take you out of Google+ to that specific YouTube video. Back now to What's Hot and Recommended. And as you can see, this post has several social media hashtags. So I'm going to click on the first one, and that will bring up related content. And then if we click on the hashtag at the top, that will take us to that dedicated stream for that content. And then again, I can choose to filter accordingly. Another thing you can do within the Google Plus search function is to look for circles. Taking the example of social media circles, when you search, you'll find that people have put together, and in this case shared publicly, circles of people that are working within that particular business. And there are circles for everybody, from science to literature to art. So have a look for circles, because you can directly add those in from that post and either choose to add them to an existing circle or create a new circle. Let's now have a look at notifications and pick up on a few more points. You can see the people who have plus one commented, shared, or plus one to comment with their images alongside that particular post. Now, let's say I click into this one. You'll see here that people have been commenting, and of course we can plus their name and type a message and plus the comment, as well as plus one their comment, and expand to see other people's comments, and we can plus on those as well. Now, if you want to edit, you can click on edit, and you can add additional information and then resave. Now, let's say you don't want to hear from that post again. You don't want to have notifications from the post again. If you click in the upper right, you can mute the post, and that will serve that function. And if you want to unmute, you click to unmute. Worth noting, within notifications, you can see the nature of them in the corner. For instance, here we see that somebody's added me into circles. That's a community post, and that's an event. If you subscribe to a channel on YouTube and somebody uploads a new video, then we will find that you get a notification. If you click in, you can play that video directly. Let's now do a comparison when things are posted. On this one, you can see we have my name and my face and then the content of the post, and there's a video embedded. If we go to the next one, we see that there's no image embedded, and this one is into a community. We can tell that from the little icon there. If we look at this one, however, we see that my image is at the top, but somebody had originally shared it underneath. This means that I've taken up authorship of that original content. And as we come down, we can see that other people have shared it on from my share of the post. And remember that you can share from within notifications. The posts that we were just looking at are all public. If they haven't been sent public, everything else is called private, as is the case of this one. If you click on the private, it flips over and you'll see the people with whom shared it. And hopefully, because there's 4,000 people, I won't mind me using this as an example. If you come down to the share button and you want to share that on, and you think that you want to share it publicly, you'll find that the public option isn't there. You can only share it with your circles or extended circles or specific circles, individuals and so on, but you can't share it publicly. So when you originate a post, if you want it to have the maximum reach and have people share it publicly onwards, then make sure you choose the public option. Looking now at a private post initiated by you, if you go and disable reshares, you won't be able to plus a person's name into that post, which means that it stays private with the individuals with whom you shared it. Let's say you see content in a stream that you want to remove, like cat a day posts. If you click, you can mute post. That will remove it from the stream. And you can undo. If you want to remove the person from circles, you can click, and that will remove them from all circles. Only joking, Martin. Now, as I search for an individual in the top bar, we're going to go and have a look at their profile and have a look at a few of the factors on their profile. The first thing is, we can see that this one for Dennis LaBelle has a custom URL. So that's his name that he's chosen that's specific to him. Here, we see the number of circles that they're in. We see that they have a verified name as well, which is a security check in a way to make sure it's the real person. We see the information where they live, the number of people who have them in circles. We see whether it's a two-way connection, which this symbol appears when it is. Then next to that, we have the option to Hangout, which if we click will bring up a Hangout. We can send a message by clicking here as well. Jump into your settings, you'll see that if you want people to be able to send you a message from your profile, you can check that box. There are so many other options in settings. For instance, you may not want other people to find your profile in search. You may not want the hashtags to be automatically added. And you can see here that if you go up, you have many options around receiving notifications by email or by phone. So just click in and choose which ones you want. Just compare the difference for a second with Sergey Brin where we see that he still hasn't circled me, and next to it we don't have the ability to contact by message, but if you drop down here you can mute or you can report and block an individual, which we won't do. When you mute someone, they may send you a notification, but you won't receive it. And when you block someone, they will no longer be able to see or interact on posts that you make. Next, let's have a look at a page. I've searched for Plus Your Business, and that brings up this page. And you can see I'm a manager of the page. I have the option to click to manage the page. If I don't click to manage, I see it as everyone else does. First thing to note is that there's a little tick mark, which means that the website has been linked back to this page, and that the two-way link is the same as if it was a profile. But different to a profile, we have a little arrow, which means that we can share the page, and only pages have this arrow. So you can tell if you're interacting with a page or a profile by seeing if they have that arrow. You can mute and block a page the same as you can a person. The number that you see on a page is called by Google the social number, and it comes from several sources, including the number of people who are following a page or have it in circles, the number of people who have plus one'd the page, the number of people who are in a community which that page owns, and social activity on a website, as well as any other place that the plus one may be relevant. Google haven't given this specific formula for this, and sometimes it will fluctuate. Now, the same as on a profile, at the top section we have about, we have photos, and we have videos that are connected to that YouTube channel. And you'll see the same on a Google Plus profile. So you can click into any of those on people's profiles and see the content. The last things on pages. If you click in the upper right, you'll be able to see what pages you own or manage. And by clicking in, you'll be jumping straight to those. Or you can have a list directly to all of your pages. And at the bottom of this, you can add an account and actually move between different Gmail accounts. And if you want to sign out, you can sign out. A few other things on pages. But I'll have to click Manage this page to show you. We're looking at the dashboard, which you'll find on the menu. And you can see the number of followers that you have for that page. And the more followers you have, the more opportunity for your content to appear in their stream. You can start a Hangout, which is a video call aspect of a Hangout. You can see information on your connected YouTube channel. You can see notifications and view all. And you can see who can act as Plus Your Business in this case. And this means that when they are managing the page, they will appear to be, for instance, posting a comment from that page. And you can view all managers or add managers from this tab. Worth knowing that as a page, you have settings and you can do very similar things to a profile. There we have it. That was an exploration of Google+. This is Martin Sherrington. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for a lot more handy hints, tips and tricks. And please check out plusyourbusiness.com where you find a lot more information specifically for business.